Help us understand, if you will, how these suicide drones work for people on the ground. Would they be able to tell a drone attack is imminent? Would they hear something, see the drone coming? And would there be enough time to get to safety?
There would be, Layla. It's fascinating because these are called loitering munition drones. They don't have the kinds of observation that we know from most drones where they can see the attack occurring from the system itself. They are blind. They go over. They're pointed at a specific weapon system. They're pointed at a target, and they crash into them. But they sound like, when they're overhead, literally a moped. They're relatively low, less than 1,000 feet. They zoom in on the target, and the target is something that's relayed to the drone through a GPS system. So they are launched anywhere from, you know, a couple of hundred to over 2,500 kilometers away. That's what's reported. They're launched off of a 5-drone rack, and 5 drones come out of that, and they go to different targets based on a GPS grid.
And General, what does it suggest to you that Russia is turning to these drones?
Well, truthfully, it suggests that they're running out of their own system. If these were Russian drones, which they had at the start of this campaign, you'd say they're continuing their assault. But what Russia has had to do is go to other countries to ask for munitions, not just for drone systems, which the Iranians have a plethora of drones that they can use, both ones with visual cues and with loitering capability and with the ability to seek out and research targets. But these are especially particular because they hit specific targets. They were designed by Iran with about 120 pounds or a 200 kilogram pound worth of payload. And it is actually smaller than what you would see drop from an aircraft, the smallest possible bomb that's dropped from an aircraft. But it's geared toward hitting a point target, a stationary target from a long distance away. So what Russia is doing by buying these drones is basically admitted they're out of precision weapons, or they're running low of precision weapons. Russia has turned into somewhat of a hollow army. They came into this with very poor operational objectives that they could not meet, and now they're finding themselves, after having used a lot of precision weapons against civilian targets, that they've run out of systems to launch, so they're now launching these purchased drones from Iran.
Let's talk a little bit about that, because according to a senior U.S. military official, Iran is supplying hundreds of these drones to Russia. What do you make of this Russia-Iran alliance?
Well, they've been allied for quite a while. They've exchanged military gear and ideas, and they've been closely aligned in many operations in the Middle East as well. But I think the expert that says Russia has purchased close to 100 or maybe more of these drones, I think we're at the very tip of that. We're going to see Russia probably trying to get literally thousands of these kinds of drones, and it's certainly going to be problematic for Ukraine because, truthfully, it's very difficult to defend against these weapons. They have a very low radar signature, so you can't pick them up as they're coming into target. They have a very small payload. And Russia has, as I said before, they're gearing these to hit civilian targets, which is an indicator of just the amount of war crimes they are committing by targeting civilians and infrastructure of the Ukrainian government.
Lieutenant General Mark Hertling is a CNN military analyst and former commanding general of the U.S. Army, Europe, and 7th Army. Thank you so much for speaking to us.
It's a pleasure, Layla. Thank you.